onside action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Nice run there. Weber picks up about 4 yards after keeping the ball on the option. From their own 29-yard line. Second down. And he carries the ball for a nice game. 5 yards there for the quarterback.
That'll make it third and one.
Makes it to the 47.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. The defender had it and then dropped it.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Here's the halfback on the screen. He's at the 30. And he's tackled around the 17-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 17-yard line. He fights forward to about the 16. The 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their scheme.
Here's the 8th play of the series. And down he goes at about the 5-yard line.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
From the 5-yard line, second down. To the end zone, intercepted. He tried to force that one in there.
Yep, and the safety made him pay for it. Great job of watching the quarterback's eyes and even a better catch.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Second and 13. Ball on the 17-yard line. Catches it, and that's Thompson. Gains 4 yards on that reception. He's got room, and they make the stop at about the 31.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. That makes it second and eight. It's second and eight. Ball on 34. Around the 45-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He's tackled at about the 41. This is the eighth play of this drive. The right side. He's taken down around the 38-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Ready. Check, check. Hammerhead. Hammerhead.
Draw play. Taken down in the backfield. Tenth play of the drive.
Ready, green, huh?
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
So it's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And it hits the upright. No good. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Offense.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
So first down once again, but a long ways to go after that penalty. Excellent open field tackle.
So at the end of one quarter, still no score.
Welcome back to the action. Just about set to start quarter number two, and we're all tied up. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. There's a strike complete. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
Well, we've got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He might have a chance. And he's taken down at the 39. Larry, Larry.
zips it to the tight end. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's got an opening. Makes it out to about the 20. Defense has been in this situation before. They forced a huge turnover when they were backed into their own red zone last time. Gets it out quickly. Inside the 10, and he shoved out of bounds around the 6-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he's tackled after positive yardage. This play is number 8 on the drive. And he's tackled at the 1-yard line. Third down and goal to go. 1 yard to the goal line. Not going to get there. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Weber looks ready to kick this one off. Young takes it at the 14, tackled at the 25-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. On the ground with the tailback. Loose football. And they fall on the loose ball. He takes it right side for a good game. We got an injured player on the field. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Ready.
He gets to about the 41-yard line.
That's a deep
one.
They bring him down in the backfield. The Tigers will use their first time out of the half. 2 minutes left in the half. Loss of one there for the halfback. Just throws this one away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
He wants it all, going long. Almost picked off. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now, hitting on all cylinders.
And he is drilled at the 22-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Throws it in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds around the 32-yard line.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 32. He's tackled in the open field. Second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He gets rid of this one. And a quick throw. And they make the stop at the 35-yard line. The Falcons are going to call their second timeout. From the 35-yard line, it's first down. He's hit and taken down. They'll bring him down at the 23. The extra point. A 9-play, 80-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see how the offense rebounds after fumbling on their last possession.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Dumps it complete over the middle.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Here we go. Green, check, check. Tiger.
And he's going to be sacked.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page. And they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
Tackle around the 42-yard line. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Pressure coming, and the ball is loose. Picked up by the defense. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Falcons with a 10-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. All week long, when I would think about this game, I thought that we were going to have a nip-and-tuck affair from start to finish. Now you look up, the margin is a couple of possessions, a couple of scores. It's a great opportunity for this team to come out in the second half and put this thing away.
Yeah, you knew it was going to be a close game, and you feel fortunate to be on the right side of making some big plays. And You don't necessarily know, Reese, if that's going to happen in the second half, so you got to take advantage of this lead. Make sure that you don't squander it. Make sure you don't make mistakes in the second half. But if you're looking at it right now, you're going, I'm pretty excited. I'm up 2 scores, and everything's going in the right direction.
That's
going
to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Falcons continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They get to the quarterback, and now the ball is loose. He's tackled around the 16-yard line.
Boy, the end really showed some explosiveness there in getting to the loose ball.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? And goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And he gets the touchdown. Job by the offense to get the final few yards to the end zone.
Yeah, they knew what play to call for in that situation and made it work.
He makes the PAT. Weber has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think I can count on one hand the last time I saw this good a defensive performance where you had a chance for a shutout. Are you kidding me? In college football today, with the spread and the running quarterbacks and all the speed in space, these guys got a chance to put up a shutout.
They give to the tailback. Nice run there.
That makes it second and six.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 29-yard line.
Ready, hot, green, 95.
He's taken down at about the 45. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Makes it to the 47. Taylor gains 8 yards on that play.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That makes it first and 10.
And he hits him hard at the 35.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five. Ball on the 35.
Set. Ready. Team. Ready.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 5 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
Makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Hands it to the back. Inside the 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Looking for the corner. He's in for the score, and they're back in it.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Falcons really had a tough first half, and I got to give them credit for hanging in there and turning things around here in the third quarter.
You're right, Brad. They could have just shut it down as bad as they looked in the first half, but great perseverance by the entire offensive unit. It's paid off. Back-to-back drives now. They've gotten points up on the board.
He makes it to the 25-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Brought down around the 35-yard line. Taken down around the 45-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on their own 45. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 4. That'll make it 7-7.
Made at about the 47-yard line.
That's a few yards on that. Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. He heaves it to the end zone. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Taylor awaiting the return. And this one is a beauty. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
And he's tackled around the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line. First down. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
That'll make it 77.
knocked out of bounds
at about the 37-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, the Falcons lead 17-7. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Gives it off. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. He makes his way to about the 42.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 42-yard line. First down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Slings it, and down he goes at about the 33-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. And this direction play gets maybe a yard at the most.
Sure, the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It to the back. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. The Tigers taking their first time out of the half. Second and 9. Ball on the 45. Tackled after decent pickup. Bishop gets about 4 yards on the play. The Tigers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. They make the stop at the 32.
To be successful, you've got to be able to come through on third down, and that's just what they did with that big run.
From the 32-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down at the 21-yard line. Inside the 10. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. This is the 8th play of this drive. should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Today, not what he expected from himself. He's just got to go on to the next week.
Well, he's going to have to shake this off. This was not obviously one of his better performances. The team ends up losing this football game, but hopefully they're able to put it behind them and move on and try to get better next week.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.